What's good, guys? Welcome back to another Mornings with Murph. I'm Terrence Murphy. We did some NFL playoff picks last time, so I wanted to keep going with those picks. Last time we did the picks, I was 50%, which is not terrible. But I did call. I did say that I was rooting for the Texans, so I feel like I should be, you know, I should get that one. Definitely didn't think that Philly was going to go down the way that they did. And definitely didn't think Dallas was going to go down in the heartbreaking fashion that they did. I know a lot of Dallas Cowboys fans are shitty as per my trolls, my comments. But I did say, I told you guys, Mike McCarthy, he's notorious for not showing up in the big games. LaFleur is a much better coach, and it showed during that game. So the next few weekends or the next upcoming games that we have, first game on Saturday the 20th, 1:30 on ESPN, we got the Texans versus the Ravens. Texans at Ravens, and this is going to be a good game. I'm very excited about this game. Two black quarterbacks, black head coach for one. I normally root for everybody black, but I think if as far as this game, is going to be a lot of different things. So let's get into it. Coaching wise, I said it last week that I was really impressed with the way that D'Amico Ryans had been coaching all season. I thought Kevin Stefanski was going to have a few more tricks for that Houston offense, but D'Amico handled everything well. That defense, I mean, you really didn't even. The composure that C.J. Stroud had during that game, you didn't even really know that that was a top defense in the league, you know. So we're moving on to now probably one of the next best top defense versus the Ravens. I think it's going to be a little bit different. These guys have been preparing for 2 weeks, watching the tape on C.J. Stroud. So as far as the coaching edge, I think I'm going to lean a little bit towards Harbaugh. And the Ravens, it bit me in the ass going against D'Amico last week. But again, I need to see it consistently. He showed us against the Cleveland Browns, D'Amico, that he had all the tools on defense. There were a couple clips where he was assisting the defense, showing them, putting them in the right position, and a couple big plays happened because of his coaching. But I think I'm going to lean towards Harbaugh. He's been there before, been to a Super Bowl before. So I think we'll go. I'm gonna lean towards his coaching and having all these guys prepared. I know that they had a first. They were number one. I think it was like 2019, 2020. They were number one seed in the playoffs, and they faced similar to this. They faced a hot team coming in versus the Titans, and they took it for granted. I don't think that is gonna happen again. They're going to learn. I think they're going to learn from that mistake. And I think that the coaching is going to be there. As far as offense in this game, this is a really tough one because I'm a big fan of running the football, which the Ravens do probably the best in the league. And I love the pieces that the Ravens have. OBJ, Zay Flowers is coming into his own. Mark Andrews is expected to be back. I'm not sure. I saw that he was practicing this week. Aguilar, who's their number two there? I'm not sure if Bateman is playing, but they have some Isaiah Likely. They have some quality running backs. They just signed Dalvin Cook. So I think they're going to be good as far as running the ball. Lamar has shown that he's a much improved passer. CJ Stroud is hard to bet against this guy from what we've seen him destroying the Cleveland's defense, but I think I would lean more towards the consistency that I've seen from the Ravens this season as far as getting touchdowns and being one of the top offensive scoring teams in the league. 28.4 points a game. Houston's not far behind, 23 points a game for the season. So I think I'm going to go with Baltimore's offense. Defensively, I think I'm going to lean towards the Ravens defense. opponents points per game. It's the lowest in the league, 16.5. Houston is, again, right, not too far off at 20.4 points a game. Just I know what I'm going to get from Roquan Smith. Great corners, great secondary play. The linebackers for the Ravens are probably the best in the league. I love Houston, D'Amico Ryans, and how he was able to really put his players in a great position to succeed last week. But I still can't forget how easy it was for Jonathan Taylor to run on them the last regular season game versus the Texans. And I feel like it's going to be a similar fashion for these running backs in Baltimore. Defensively, we said offense. So coaching, it's a 3-3 so far. Intangibles, again, I think I'm going to lean more towards the Baltimore side in this game. Again, intangibles is energy, charisma, moxie, you know, experience, all these things. I think that favors Baltimore side. It's not great experience. Lamar is 1-3 in career playoff games. Total QBR 41.5, but I believe that his experience thus far is going to elevate him in this particular playoff game. I think that those numbers are going to be aberration. Those are going to be just something that affected him previously, and not having the experience that he's gained thus far. So I think I'm going to easily pick Baltimore in this game. I'm rooting for Houston. I mean, I'm rooting for Baltimore more in this game, but I'm rooting for the success of Houston's team. I love, again, I'm always rooting for everybody black head coach, black QB. They are doing special things, and I think it's going to be too much. But again, I can't count out the Houston Texans, but I believe that Baltimore will win this game.